Hi, my name is Caroline.
And I'm Maria.
And we're the founders and co-directors of Atlas Middle School. So at Atlas, all of our academics connect to theatrical production.
And when engaging in theater, we activate the tools of our bodies, voices, and minds. So we start every day with a warm-up. Let's engage your tools. So everybody just start out by noticing tension in your body. Put your head to one side, give yourself a little neck rub. Head to the other side, give yourself a little neck rub. Even if you're sitting at a desk, this can be super helpful. Reach your right hand into the air and your left hand to the floor and switch both hands up and around, shoulders back, and roll your shoulders forward. And if there's any remaining tension, pull it up to your ears and release with a breath. All right, now that our body's feeling a little bit more awake, let's do some tongue twisters to activate our voice. So let's go the tip of the tongue, the teeth, the lips.
The tip of the tongue, the teeth, the lips.
The tip of the tongue, the teeth, the lips.
The tip of the tongue, the teeth, the lips.
Red leather, yellow leather.
Red leather, yellow leather.
Red leather, yellow leather.
Red leather, yellow leather.
Red leather, yellow leather. Red leather, yellow leather.
Red leather, yellow leather. Red leather, yellow leather.
Toy boat.
Toy boat.
Toy boat. Toy boat.
Toy boat. Toy boat.
Toy boat. Toy boat. Toy boat.
Toy boat. Toy boat. Toy boat.
All right. And obviously our mind and our emotions are another really big part of all of the work that we do. So I'm going to pass it over to Caroline to activate your mind.
Let's activate those minds. So at Atlas, we're not about just regurgitating facts. We want you to think, and we want our students to think about their thinking. So one of the thinking routines we do is called See, Think, Wonder. And you can do that with anything. You can do hear, think, wonder with music. You can look at art. You can look at student work if you're a teacher. But we're going to look at a piece of artwork right now. And the first thing I want you to do as you look at this piece of artwork is just to see and say what you see. Not what you think you see, but what you see. For example, I see that there's blue leading to a lighter blue as it goes down the image. I see that there are colorful squares and squares within those colorful squares. So you want to try not to add your judgment to it. You might want to say, I see buildings. You don't know that those are buildings. It's just what you see. Then you can move on to what you think or what you think you see. So I think I see an urban landscape. I think I see images flying above that landscape, and I think that might mean that they're trying to be free or express their freedom in some way. And you can go on and on like that. And then you want to say what you wonder about the image. So, for example, I wonder who created this image. I wonder what materials were used. I wonder if this is something really personal or something that speaks to the world or a little bit of both. And you can go on and on like that. And like I say to my students, it's more important that you have questions than you have answers. So the more questions you come up with, the better. And another thinking routine we use is called I used to think, but now I think. So we do that after reading a book or reading an article because our minds are changing. They're always changing. Even as adults, our minds are changing. And it's really important to remember that. So for example, I used to think that colorblindness was the right way to think about race. But now I think that everyone has a unique identity and we need to honor that identity when we're talking about people and speaking with people and just being with people. That's really important. We want to get away from that fixed mindset. So I used to think, now I think is a great thinking routine for doing that.
Well, thank you for taking a little time with Atlas today. We hope we've activated your bodies, voices, and minds.